So as you settle into your breathing...
All it took was this article in the New York Times to knock the Zen out of the yoga community. The headline, How Yoga Can Wreck Your Body.
When you first read the article, how did you feel about it?
When I first read the article, I was sort of shocked a little bit, sort of, kind of alarmed at the extremity, it seemed, of the talk on how yoga can wreck your body. I thought that was just a very extreme statement.
While the article angered yoga instructor Gina Minyard at first, she told us she's the poster child for it.
Have you ever been injured doing yoga?
I have been injured doing yoga. When I first started doing yoga 12 years ago, I came into the yoga studio with a lot of imbalance in my body. I'd been in an accident and my body was very sort of twisted and unaddressed imbalances that were there.
1 year into practicing yoga, Minyard injured her hamstring and shoulder during routine poses. But the injury wasn't all bad, she says.
The same poses where I hurt myself, I actually was able to create healing. And then, too, the issues that I had from my badly broken leg from my accident have healed beyond, like, kind of everyone's wildest dreams through yoga.
In the article, New York Times senior writer William J. Broad writes that yoga can cause serious injuries such as nerve damage, strokes, muscle damage, torn cartilage, even cracked ribs.
What really stands out to you? What do you think the article really got wrong?
Pulling like these studies from the 70s with what sounded to me like people who were doing yoga kind of more on their own, like in their dorm room, for instance, and not with the guidance of a teacher.
You question their examples.
I'm not saying clearly they're legitimate, like they're documented, but I just think it was to support the side of the article about how yoga can wreck your body, but it wasn't the full picture. It was just too specific and too almost unusual to show what really, what often happens.
I'm one of the tens of millions of Americans who practice yoga, and while anyone can get into a pose, the yoga instructors we spoke with say the best way to avoid injury is to find a studio with qualified, experienced teachers.
So here, right? Then you move forward, you're here, right?
In the 14 years Joe Polisi has been teaching yoga, he has never had any injuries in his classes. But he says they do happen if students don't use proper technique.
I think a lot of the injuries that this gentleman was describing in the article could possibly have been created through doing something over and over and over incorrectly, out of alignment, and or pushing way too hard in a pose.
A little bit tight there.
Physical therapist David Paschon agrees with Broad's claims that many injuries are possible in yoga. But he also agrees with the scores of outraged yoga fanatics who feel the article was alarmist and didn't provide the proper context in the examples used.
Reading that article, if somebody wasn't familiar with yoga, or let's say they were planning on doing yoga, if they read that article, they'd say, oh, let me find something else to do. And so in that aspect, no, I don't think it was fair. There was too many negatives thrown out. Obviously, with more people doing a form of exercise, you're going to have more injury, whether it's softball, baseball, football, whatever. When they pick and choose, these specific injuries, yes, some injuries like that do happen.
Broad told us he's glad that his book and the excerpt in the paper are, quote, stirring a debate on safety. In a statement to CNN, he said, quote, the evidence suggests that smart changes in personal routines can help prevent serious injuries and even save lives. This may seem surprising given yoga's reputation for gentleness. But as the book shows, decades of scientific studies have revealed many ways that the practice of yoga can be improved.
Chin back to the mat. Bend your knees, take your ankles, stretch.
If that's true, it's going to take a lot more than tales of injury from long ago to convince yogis around the globe they may be wrecking their body. Randy Kay, CNN, Atlanta.